very extreme and disturbing. See this woman? All right, let's put her at full mast here. This is a former Colorado child protection caseworker who is now, who has now been charged. Why? Because according to multiple individuals, she would make advances, sexual advances. And when those sexual advances were rejected, she would then engage in a process to get the child removed from the household of the parent she tried to sleep with. That is diabolical. Her name is Robin Niceta. Ms. Niceta is listed as a defendant in a lawsuit alleging she tried to punish moms who rejected her advances by having their children taken away from them. I cannot think of anything more egregious that a child worker can do. What? Actually, only one thing more egregious than that. Niceta now faces felony charges for retaliation against an elected official. I'm going to get into that in a moment, as well as a misdemeanor charge of making a false report of child abuse as a mandatory reporter. The alleged offenses happened when that woman worked in the County Department of Human Services. According to a criminal complaint, Niceta called the DHS anonymously to report that a local city councilwoman, Danielle Jurinsky, sexually abused her own son in the presence of staff. Okay, that never happened. That was completely untrue. Completely untrue. The complaint, however, alleges that Niceta used a personal phone to make the call of this untrue thing, and that the authorities investigated the case found the allegations to be completely untrue, non-factual. There's more. Authorities believe that Niceta made the call after the councilwoman Jurinsky appeared on a local radio show and called for the firing of the Aurora police chief, who was Nasita's girlfriend at the time. Now you gotta follow this. Nasita's girlfriend was the police chief that the councilwoman, said this person needs to be fired for misconduct. Okay? Now things have gotten worse for this once trusted individual in the community. After Jurinsky filed a civil lawsuit against Niceta and the County Department of Human Services because of this ridiculous allegation, several other women came forward. Nobody saw this coming. These other women, what did they allege? They're saying that Ms. Niceta, when a county child protective caseworker would lure them in, make sexual advances towards them, and then, and when the advances were rejected, Niceta would try to take their children away, utilizing her official position as a child protective worker. The attorney for the councilwoman Jurinsky has filed documents asking for a class action lawsuit for, and I quote, well over 40 persons whose families were affected by Niceta's alleged actions. Here's what this means. Now, to file a class action lawsuit, you have to get a judge to certify the class action lawsuit. So you actually appeal to the court to certify that this is a category for class action. Before you can do that, you have to make a good faith basis, a claim that you have identified enough of the elements to make this a class action. For example, you have to identify how many individuals have already been adversely affected, which means more than likely this law firm representing the councilwoman, they have already engaged in over 40 different conversations with families connected to the adverse reality of this once trusted public servant. So damn sad. All right, Jeff, thoughts on this case?
What a disgusting abuse of power. This was a trusted individual in this community, and they're using their title in order for their own personal gain. Like, this is gross. And we both know, everyone watching knows, there are far more than 40 individuals that are involved in this civil action lawsuit. So I hope justice prevails and something like this can be put down really quick.
Yeah, and here's the thing. There are others who may not be aware of the potential class action lawsuit. So that's part of the reason why I'm highlighting this, so that everyone who has been adversely affected by this individual can actually have their day in court, possibly. Also, the rules, the checks, the balances need to be strengthened in that local community to make sure that others who have this level of public trust do not engage in such a violation.